A very good morning to all of you students. Myself, Rinaldi Priyam, your chemistry teacher, and this is your chemistry book. The picture of the cover page of the book I have sent into the WhatsApp group. Okay, students, and also I have sent you the syllabus regarding this book, your chemistry book. Because from that syllabus you will be able to get in that which chapter belongs to which term. The terms are
from page number 7, your chapter number 1 matter gets started in your book. Okay, anything which occupies space and has mass is called matter. Means matter is the substance which occupies space and have mass. Okay, what is mass, students? Mass means the thing which is having any weight. Okay, so anything which occupy any space, okay, and have its own weight is known as matter. Okay, in our daily life we see lots of matter. For example, any solid thing is also a matter, any liquid thing is also a matter, and also the gaseous thing are also known as matter. So if we talk about matter, students, matter is made up of atoms and molecules. Okay, atoms and molecules. Atoms are the smallest particle of matter. Okay, and the molecules are formed by the combination of atoms. Means you can say that molecules are just not more simple as the atoms are. Okay, here we can study. On the other hand, molecules exist independently. Okay, they form by the combination of atoms. Here see, it's written that molecules are formed by the combination of atoms. Both particles cannot be seen with the naked eyes, but the main you can say the similarity between the both are that not atoms nor molecules can be seen with our naked eyes. Okay, after that, main postulates of kinetic molecular theory of matter. See, student, this is very important thing of this chapter, that what were the main postulate which were given by the kinetic molecular theory of matter, which means kinetic molecular theory of matter is very much important. The main postulates of kinetic molecular theory of matter are as follows. Matter consists a large number of small particle. Means, as I told you, that matter is made up of atoms and molecule, which means matter is consisting large amount of atoms and molecule. Okay, atoms or molecules. Okay, the particles are in continuous and random motion and have kinetic energy. And if any matter contain atoms or molecule, obviously they have motion inside them. So the random motion inside the matter is produced kinetic energy. Okay, and they have their kinetic energy. If heat energy is provided to matter, its particle move faster. If you apply heat to any matter, the movement of that particle get increases. Okay, that means kinetic energy increases. Okay, if the distance between the particles of matter increases, the force of attraction decreases. So if one particle is here and second particle is here, the force of attraction between them is less. But if they are near to one another, the force of attraction will be increases. Okay, After that, classification of matter. Matter is classified on the basis of physical state, appearance and composition. Means how the physical state of the matter is, how the matter look alike and what is the composition of the matter. On the basis of these three properties, matter is classified. Okay. First, classification on the basis of physical state. Okay. So, the first classification which we are going to study today is classification on the basis of physical state. The first physical state is solids and their properties. Okay. So, matter exists in three forms: solid, liquid or gas. Okay. So, the first which we are going to study is solids and their properties. The state of matter having definite shape and definite volume is called solid. So, solid is that part of matter, or you can say the matter which are solid in nature have definite volume, okay, and definite shape are called solid. Few important properties of solids are as follows. The particle of solids are very closely packed, means the particles, which means atoms and molecules of solid are very closely packed. Solids are rigid, but some solids like sponge can be compressed because sponge has pores. See, the nature of solid is that they are rigid in their nature, but some solids are not having so rigid property. Okay. There are some compressible solids also, which means the solid which we are able to compress. So, one more type of solid which we are able to see is rubber. Rubber is a kind of elastic solid. Sponge is a kind of, means sponge belong to compressible solid and the rubber belongs to elastic solid. What is the difference between compressible solid and elastic solid? Compressible solid, we will be able to compress it, and elastic solid are the solid which when stretch gets into its original position while not applying that stretch. Okay. The distance between the particles, atoms or molecule in matter is called intermolecular distance. Okay. So, students, if this is a matter, inside the matter these are the particles. So, distance between the particles, means the atoms and molecules, are known as intermolecular distance. Okay. In solid, the intermolecular distance is very small, means the distance between one to another particle is very small. The force of attraction between the particles is called intermolecular force, which means, students, the force which is acting between the molecule is known as intermolecular force. If two solids are in contact with each other, no diffusion takes place. If you place two solids with one another, there will be no diffusion takes place. Diffusion is the process, students, in which the substance goes from the higher concentration to lower concentration. Okay. After that, solid have high density. What is the meaning of density, students? Density is the term which defines mass per unit volume, means how much quantity of, means how much atoms or molecules are present in a particular volume. Okay. So, if the number, or you can say that amount of particle or atoms will be larger in a particular volume, the greater will be its density. The second form will be, students, liquid and their properties. So, the second form is liquid. The state of matter having indefinite shape. Here inside the liquid you can see indefinite shape, means their shape is not definite. Inside the solid we had studied, student, they have definite shape and definite volume, but here you can see indefinite shape and definite volume, means the shape is indefinite but the volume is definite, is called liquid. Now the properties of liquid, students, the particle of liquid is less closely packed in comparison to solid. Okay, liquid take the shape of the container. If you fill the container with a particular liquid, the liquid will be take the shape of that particular container. Intermolecular distance of liquid is larger than solid, means the distance between the particles of liquid will be more than that of solid. Intermolecular force of liquid are lesser, and as I had told you that the greater will be the distance between the molecules will decrease the intermolecular force. Density of liquid is lesser than solid. Okay, the density of the liquid is lesser than the solid. Why it is so, students? Because in a particular volume, the number of atoms and molecule will be smaller than that of solid. Liquids expand when heated and contract on cooling. So if we heat any liquid, it gets expanded. If we cool any liquid, it gets contracted. For example, ice, student, you can see if we boil water, you can see the dilution of water. But if we cool the water, it gets converted into ice. Okay, the liquid can diffuse into another liquid. Okay, if we place two liquid with each other, they get diffused inside one another. For example, milk and water diffuses in each other, but oil and water does not get diffused. Okay, means there are only some liquid which get diffused and some which does not get diffused. Now the third types of matter on the basis of physical properties, gaseous, means gases. So here we are going to study gases and their property. The state of matter having indefinite shape and indefinite volume is called gas. So here you can see that, student, gas indefinite shape and indefinite volume, means gas has no definite shape and no definite volume. So what is the properties of gas? The particles of liquids are closely packed. Okay, gases occupies the entire space available. Okay, intermolecular distance between gases particle is very large. Here you can see, in comparison to liquid, students, the intermolecular force between the particles of gas is very less, because the particles which are situated in gas are very far from one another. Okay, gas expands to the large extent when heated, and bit in comparison to liquid, it expand more on heating. Which particle? Gaseous particle. Okay, gases contract on cooling, but if we cool the gas, it will be get contracted. Okay, gases diffuses very quickly into the one another. If you place two gases with each other, they get diffuses inside themselves. Density of gas is very low. As I had told you, students, density depend upon the mass per unit volume. So here you can see the least density is of gas. Okay, students, in our next class we will study states of matter based on kinetic molecular theory.